You're welcome. Let's solve this question. So what you have here is, say, given that the functions of x is root x, and the functions of g is what? 25 minus x squared. So you have to find the value of f of g. That's the component of, when this one is component of the other. So what are you going to do here? So what's functions of x? So you can call the functions of x y like this, y equal to root x. So the functions of g, call it z. So you have it to be what? 25 minus x squared. So what is this saying? That this one is the functions of this, is functions of x, as they put it. So you, that is what you have there is, where, well, let's say you have fx and what, gx, and this is x. So what they are saying is that the functions of this g, this is x, is in this, that is, is implied this one. So you can express this one like as fg, f of g like this. You can express it as f equal to what? Root of, where you see x here. So you place this one there. 25 minus x squared. Then you have to find this. Say that find the value of x. So you have to find the value of x. Okay, you have to find the value of this. So the g here that you are seeing here is x. So what's x here? So you are going to have 25 minus 3 squared. So you will have 25 minus 9. So this one is going to give you 16. Therefore, your answer is 4. So look at this one here also. So what you have here is, if this is this, so you have to find the value of x. So what you are seeing here is x minus 6 over g x equal to this. So what are you going to do? Say square root. So you say square both sides. So you square both sides. That is x minus 6 x square like this. So equal to 1 square. So you can expand this one. So you expand. So you expand this. So equal to 1. Now, root x times root x is x. So you have this one as x. Then root x times this. So you will have 6 root x over root x. Again, this multiplied by this minus 6 root x over root x plus, multiply this with this, 6 times 6 is 36. Minus times minus is plus. So you, what you are seeing here, and root 6, root x times root x is going to give you x. So equal to 1. This cancel this, this cancel this. You will have x minus 6 minus 6 plus 36 over x equal to 1. So that's that is that. So what you have here, is x minus 12. So you have minus 6 minus 6, you have 12. So plus 36 over x equal to what? 1. So you can take this to this side. So take minus 12 to the other side. So you will have x plus 36, x equal to 1 plus 12. So you will have x 36 over x equal to what? 13. Now, as you are getting to this side, so what you can do is you can multiply through by what? X. So here you have multiply through by x. So x times s, you have s squared. If you multiply s with this, we have 36 equal to 13 squared, 13x. What you are seeing here is x times x here, multiply this one by x, so x will cancel x. Then bring this one to this side, you have x squared minus 13x plus 36 equal to 0. Then, now if you want to factorize this, so what are you going to use to factorize? You want to factorize this, so look for factor of 36. So what are the factor of 36? You have one, several numbers, two number like that, you can have as factor of this. Among them, you will have 4 and 9. So here you need two numbers. So if you add them together, you are going to have minus 13. If you multiply them together, you are going to have plus 36. So it's going to be minus 4 and minus 9. So minus 4 plus minus 9 is going to give you this. Minus 4 times minus 9 is going to give you 36. So what you have here is this, minus 4x minus 9x plus 36 equal to 0. So what you have here is x squared minus 4x into brackets, 9x into bracket 36 equal to 0. So what you see here, when you put brackets here, minus times plus is going to give you minus. So that's why this sign changed to minus here. When you put bracket, if you multiply this by this, you get this one back. So what is common here is x. So you add x minus 4 into bracket 9. So x minus 4 equal to 0. So you will have 4. What is common here is 4. So you combine this with this, x minus 9 equal to 0. So what you have here again is x minus 4 equal to 0 or x minus 9 equal to 0. So you have x equal to 4 or x equal to 9. So that is what you have. Well, then you want to check which one is your answer here. You have 4 here. So place 4 here. If x equal to 4, so root 4, that's going to give you 2. 6, this root 4 also 2. 6 divided by 2 is going to give you 3. Is it equal to minus 1? No. Because this one was equal to this. So this minus this is going to give you minus 1. So that is not the 4 is not the answer. Then let's look at 9. So place 9 here. 9 root 9 is going to give you 3 minus 3 again, 6 divided by 3, 2 equal to 1. So 3 minus 2 is 1. Therefore, your answer equal to what? 9. So that's the answer is 9. Thanks for watching.